Hi, I'm Tim Delbridge, and I'm an assistant professor in the Department of Applied Economics at Oregon State University. Risk is a part of any business, and this is certainly true of businesses in the ag and food sectors.
As we watch the cost rise across the board.
Agribusiness firms face risks that all businesses face, including the risk that interest rates might go up and it could cost more to borrow, or the risk that there's a general slowdown in the economy and people are forced to spend less on their products. Unlike firms in many other industries, agribusiness firms often see the prices of their products fluctuate on commodity markets on a daily basis. Crop and livestock producers have to face the risk that adverse weather conditions or pest pressure reduces the yields on their own operations. And processed food producers and retail grocery stores may see price increases or supply disruptions because their suppliers face production challenges. Producers and processors of perishable foods must manage complicated supply chains and logistics with much less flexibility than is enjoyed by businesses and other industries. Food companies also face significant risks associated with food safety. Food safety incidents can have serious health consequences for consumers and can be severely damaging to a firm's reputation and profitability. The unique nature of risk in the ag and food industries makes agribusiness risk management a bit different than risk management in other industries. There are similar considerations related to managing employees, contracts, and facilities, but the natural and biological processes introduce a lot of complexity. As such, we see farms and other agribusiness firms use different types of risk management tools. For example, farmers of some crops have a unique risk management tool available in the form of crop insurance, which helps them manage the risk of low prices and the risk of low yields. Buyers and sellers of agricultural commodities might also participate in futures markets to reduce their exposure to price risk. Farmers might use futures markets to protect against the risk of falling prices, while buyers, say a large dairy farm that buys corn to feed their cows, or a flour mill that buys wheat to make their flour, might use future markets to protect themselves against the risk of rising prices. Above all else, good risk management in the food and ag industries requires that managers understand the risks that they face, which is easier said than done. Managers need to ask themselves which risks they're facing, how likely those bad outcomes are to occur, and how bad it will be for the business if the bad outcome does occur. For example, a short period of low crop prices is very likely to occur, but is not likely to threaten a firm's existence. A food safety outbreak originating at the farm might be unlikely, but if it did happen, it could be catastrophic. Even though less likely, the business may want to spend more time and money figuring out how to manage this low probability event. There's a lot to talk about with risk management in agriculture, so check out the other Applied Economic Dictionary entries that are coming soon on risk aversion, crop insurance, and futures markets.